Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip. Gotta get dip.
That's a great way to start every podcast.
Yeah, Black Eyed Peas. Damn nice.
I know. No taps this time around, guys.
Why not?
Yeah, Sean's dead. He's been dead.
Sean's long gone. Just kidding, buddy. If you're out there somewhere, we miss you.
If you're listening.
Absolutely.
No, you're
if
not.
If you're somehow finding this and listening, dude, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, if you're subscribed to Crustman Gaming, taps.
You notice any activity in your subscriber count?
No, yeah, no. Actually, I have noticed a lack of activity in my subscriber count.
Coast Guard _ anonymous.
Yeah, no. Probably from Coastal, for sure.
Yeah, well, I mean, Tim officially took his spot today, so this is big day in the league.
I was going to say, now it's official.
Yeah, it's on a hypothetical schedule that I got on week one. It's got the boys rowdy in Smart Town.
Yeah, that's up for... up for change though when we have Josh on the pod later, biggest cracker, but he did finish first in his division, so he gets the draft
against me.
Curious against you. Yeah, I forgot you were in first place.
Yeah, that's people insane. Forget
that is crazy.
People forget.
You going for a chip this year or what?
Yeah, I think that's the idea for most teams.
Yeah, that's kind of the goal.
Well, if you're treating it like fantasy baseball where the person with the least amount of points is actually in first, then I'd agree with that as well. Is that true?
Not how that works.
Fuck.
The least person with the least amount of points is in last.
Oh, shit.
Which is you.
I thought it was like a golf thing. I was like, dude, I'm up by 30.
That was almost a good analogy.
I'm up by 30.
Talk about that, too.
Fantasy baseball? Pass.
No. Well, then I have fantasy baseball. Liv. On our talking points. I was talking about Liv.
Yeah. Liv.
Yeah. And that draft, too. I don't even know like how that draft worked and everything. But, I mean, we'll talk about that later.
They should have done an auction draft with Saudi oil. Would have been awesome.
This is drafting a bunch of Saudis.
8 barrels on Mickelson.
Betting barrels of oil?
Yeah, that would have been sick.
Yeah, whatever.
All right. Should I roll the dice?
No.
We can
start
that way.
Oh, save that for later. I mean,
I'll be like a little intermission.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I said, we are an entertainment station.
True that.
But at the same time, I feel like fucking guys like Chuck are like, oh, there's not enough football. There's not enough. You guys don't talk any league sports. So we're going to do NFL news first, Chuck. This one's for you, buddy.
Woo!
Literally on the NFL news. I'm on the NFL latest news page right now, and we have Chargers safety Derwin James spends the offseason recovering following shoulder surgery.
Wow. That's
awesome.
And we have former NFL wide receiver Golden Tate signing with Summer Collegiate Baseball Team.
Ooh, riveting.
And, oh my God, look at this picture of Deshaun Watson. Man. He definitely assaulted someone.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah. Mike was showing me earlier today. That's real
news.
Yeah.
Should we get everyone's thoughts on that?
On Deshaun Watson?
Yeah, we didn't talk about it last time.
Hey, guys, drop it in the chat. I'm over under 22.5 checks for Deshaun Watson.
Over.
I saw him talking to the media earlier, and somebody straight up asked him, like, is 66 a real number? And he was like, oh, I don't believe that. That's like, not what my lawyers want me to believe.
What a stupid it's question, 90. Too, though. When, oh, 66 a real number?
As if he's going to say yes.
Oh, yeah. You know what? Look, he caught me.
Dude, most of them were dudes.
I've been fighting this for a year, but you know what?
That was a good question.
I've been denying everything for a year, but that one. I'll admit to that. 66?
Dude, he looks dirty right now. I'm gonna screenshot this, and I'm going to send
Is that our thumbnail?
Yes, this should be tonight's thumbnail.
I still can't believe
it. Should we also put Noah and Josh right next to
that? That prom?
All right, yeah, edit that together for me. I'll make it the
thumbnail. I would love for you guys to recreate that, by the way. If you guys do recreate that same exact picture in the same tuxes and everything in Drexel Brook, I'll pay for your dues this year.
Wow.
Which I don't know if that's worth it, but
you might have to give like your first round pick. Your first two rounds?
Nah, can't do draft pick trading yet.
Yeah,
wait till I roll snake eyes.
I mean, there's... Fuck, I don't know.
Two clovers, maybe?
Cooper Kupp's new contract. That's big time. I was never, like, big on the
former Panthers and Packers wide receiver Devin Funchess, who was it, the Lions?
I don't know.
He's now a tight end for the Lions. Shout out Colin and
Michigan
alum.
Yeah, TJ Hockenson is fuming right now.
Yeah, that is an interesting signing.
NFL news is so boring right now.
Well, it is June.
Sauce Gardner paid $50,000 to his buddy to have the number one jersey on the Jets. It's pretty cool.
That's awesome, actually.
It's a fat chunk of change.
Yeah, must have been a nice signing bonus.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm bored of talking about NFL news.
That's okay.
I want to talk about something that really bothered me today in the group chat. Chuck, I mean, I know you're going to be on the show in, like, a little bit, and I'll probably bitch about it then, too, when I have you on the line. Hey, you're not the commissioner anymore, dude. Stop throwing around these paragraphs in the group, me, like you're
top dog.
Your days of terrorism are over.
You type that so fast, too. Like, he has, like, the red button.
It's definitely copied and pasted.
Yeah, bro, he definitely had that.
No, I know. I'm just, like, it's like he was sending out the missile codes.
I didn't. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I didn't even read it. I read
like half of it.
I read the top. I just said owners meeting from 8:01 to 8:05. Like,
as soon as you started talking about Noah,
That's not even up to you.
As soon as you started talking about Noah, I stopped reading.
Let's see. What is the owners meeting? Glad you asked, bro.
Yeah, no, it's true.
You can propose a rule change during that week. You can propose it. And, yeah, it could get voted on, but then, Chuck, it has to get by me. So, I...
Yeah, he's got the...
Have fun with this. Actually, you know, I'm honestly pretty lenient. It's just everything except for draft pick trading, which, you know...
It's decided by these two dice in my hand.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to give it a go, you can. And just for a quick reminder for everyone...
That doesn't count.
If I roll snake, guys...
My first rule of order was removing Sean from the league. My second one is
racist.
No draft pick trading. Unless Chris rolls snake eyes. And then if you hear it, yeah, come on, get up right in. Those are the die. Chris is about to roll. If you get snake eyes, you'll hear us hissing. Draft pick trading's back on. But if not, Chris gets another chance next pod.
Yeah. I've been stupid in trying to delay these pods. Like, I'm limiting my opportunities.
Jake and I have been wanting to record them, and you are just, no, it's early. There's nothing to talk about. Dude, we can talk for days. Entertainment station.
True. All right, should I roll these?
Hey, man, it's up to you. Hey, for me, personally, I don't even want you to roll, but...
But I'm rolling. Nope. Fuck.
That's a 3 and a 4.
7.
Better luck next time.
Crazy eights.
So this is that's between, maybe should I just get Joe Mixon or...
Yeah, actually, no, we were mock drafting here the other night, and...
Your team was pretty good.
Yeah, I've been able to convince myself that I can make something special happen even without draft pick trades, but...
Mixon and Kelsey.
But, yeah, I mean, something like that. Also, it's hard to, like, prepare for the onslaught of quarterbacks that's inevitable in our league, as it always is.
Once one goes, they all go.
Yeah, yeah, I mean...
I'm going to look at the fantasy football rankings for this year, because I feel like there's actually, like... QBs you can wait on.
100%. Last year I had the best quarterbacks in the league. I had Dak and Joe Burrow.
Last year was the first time I drafted one, like, kind of early.
I took Josh Allen, and I was like, because I'm one of those guys. And I mean, for our fantasy league purposes, like, reaching for quarterbacks, like, not terribly stupid because it's 6 point touchdowns.
I imagine that'll change this year, though, with the half point PPR.
It's not going to change. 6 point QB touchdowns?
No, but like the who you would draft.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe. So first here, I know you were talking to Ricky earlier, and he wanted you to talk about Jonathan Taylor being the first overall pick.
He's not going to listen to this.
I know, but like, I mean, you want to elaborate?
I think Jonathan Taylor is a very good football player, and I think he might have proven that to the league last year. When he rushed for like 2,000 yards and like 85 touchdowns. I don't really have much more to say about it. I don't know what list you're looking at right now, but I can already tell you that like Derrick Henry's probably not in the top tier, and I find that to be ridiculous.
Derrick Henry, he is.
Probably like third.
No, yeah, he's like third.
Oh, word.
Yeah, halfway PPR. Taylor and McCaffrey. And he catches balls, too.
No, I know. I'm just – when I was doing that mock draft yesterday, he got picked like seventh. I was like, okay, like if he was gonna get picked seventh in our league, I would be doing everything I can to move up in fantasy baseball right now. But I know he'll be gone by like the third pick, so there's no point. That's what I think. That's what people don't understand about me, Jake.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, bro, I'm not gonna lie to you. I zoned that out.
No, that's fine. Yeah, you went on a little.
No, people will talk about how Noah is like trade raping me or whatever in fantasy baseball and just like using my team. Like, first of all, who on my team is usable? Like, I think if anything,
the only person
you're trading with the wrong guy. If you're trying to build a super team in fantasy baseball, trade with somebody else.
This is my
but I don't care. I don't give a fuck. I'm in 12th place. I think that's an awesome spot to draft in fantasy football. And that's why we shouldn't be doing – we should just do a random order.
You're looking at – oh, no. Bro, you should have had this whole spiel before we decided – bro, you want to wait 2 months into baseball to be like,
I don't want to do this anymore because I'm 100 points down from the next guy ahead of me.
No, speaking of that, I know we're also talking to Josh later. Him saying something – he said something in the fucking – group me earlier today, and I was at the gym. I was like, you know what, Josh, I hate you, no cap. That's all I said.
That's terrible.
No, it's true.
Why? Because he's a cracker.
Yeah, I don't like the color of his skin.
Well, Chris,
look, or the content of his character.
Whoa, they have CeeDee Lamb as a second round pick.
Yeah, dude, he's up there,
I guess, because Amari's gone.
Yeah,
well, where's here? Amari
Cleveland. Browns.
Oh, that sucks for him.
Getting massages.
Oh,
who's going to be Cleveland's quarterback?
To NFL news. The Panthers are very set on trying to get Baker Mayfield.
That's crazy. What's Sam Darnold?
Dude, Christian McCaffrey value boost.
I would rather have Mayfield than Darnold, personally.
Oh, same.
I think you're same. He's athletic. I think it's the same difference.
No,
they're both shitty, but like Darnold.
If you're the Carolina Panthers,
Darnold
and you're
sucks. Darnold stunk.
I would not sell out for any quarterbacks.
I don't even think they'd have to sell out.
Well, no, you're right. But at the same time, they have to give something.
They also
have to take a salary, which obviously.
Can they just do a one for one trade? I'm really bad with like the whole trading and salary cap shit. Like, could
they might just Darnold toss like for, a 6th round pick, bro?
Yeah, like Darnold and a 6 for Baker, and then that way they Cleveland have to give him Darnold. What's up?
Might not even have to give him Darnold.
Well, they have Matt Corral. They just drafted him, so true. Like, they'll probably want to give him a shot.
Yeah, it just seems ridiculous to me to see the Carolina Panthers, or for that matter, like, any team's trying to trade for Baker Mayfield
this
right now.
This is so exciting for me, though, because I can get, like, Saquon in the third this year.
Like, imagine if the Steelers were trying to get Baker. Like, it's kind of the same thing in my head. Like, the Steelers just signed Trubisky, they just drafted Kenny Pickett, and now they want to get Baker Mayfield?
Wait,
for
the
what?
Steelers too?
Dwayne no, Haskins I'm just saying, died. Like, it's oh, in my head, it's like Jesus the same Christ. Thing as the Panthers.
There might be a QB spot opening on that team.
What happened? Oh, shit.
Dwayne Haskins. Do they have a
third
that's quarterback?
A three-run bomb.
Is three? That tie game?
Philly's tied it up. Oh, Reese God. Hoskins is hot.
That's awesome.
That's my fantasy team.
That is awesome.
But yeah, I mean, I think Dwayne Watson. Wait, what's his name?
Deshaun Watson.
You got my head's all fucked up now. Reese hitting bombs. I think Deshaun Watson fits incredibly well with that quarterback room culture in Pittsburgh. So
I hate a lot Dalvin of rape Cook. In that room.
Yeah, Big Ben. Big Ben won that.
You hate Dalvin Cook.
Yeah, I'm just like, look, I would never pick him fifth.
Like, he's not, I have a problem with picking most people
he's
in the
very
NFC.
Very good.
North. He's very good, and like he's easily has like the best. Like handcuff as well. So like, if he goes down and you have Madison, like
yeah.
You have Dalvin Cook still. Like it's
yeah.
That's kind of how running backs are a lot of the times, though. I feel like no, they just have a high output in Minnesota.
No, I mean, like if Derrick Henry goes down, like Jeff McNichols is not gonna put up the same number. Like Madison is like a carbon copy. Like he the dreads. And
you're
all.
Telling me I had Alexander Madison last year,
and you didn't have Dalvin Cook.
No.
I wonder who the asshole was that fucking had Dalvin and didn't pick up Madison.
Yeah, no, I don't
Look
know.
Look that up.
I think Noah had Dalvin.
What a piece of shit. Nah, he had an Eckler because he had the
or
Chargers.
Josh,
back.
Maybe? Josh, maybe?
Nah. Oh, dude, you know, I know who he is. Bonehead Boys. Look, check his roster.
It was. It was.
No. Oh, wait, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, no, that makes sense.
Yeah, I forgot.
Good thing he's dead.
See ya.
Did Noah have Moment a silence. Viking stack 1 year?
Yes.
He had a
Viking
stack. I was going to say.
Yeah. He had Jettis, Thielen.
Cousins. I still can't believe I drafted Justin Jefferson that year and dropped him for
fucking Jalen Reagor before the season started.
That will remember before Lamar's MVP year, I drafted Lamar and Mahomes. And then I dropped Lamar and I traded Mahomes or something like that.
That was absurd.
It was. I kind of want to look at that, but I don't know where I can find that, because I feel like that was a draft that we did on, like, the big board down here in the basement.
Well, that means that I was putting it in manually. Which
I would love to do an in-person draft. I don't think that's...
We could pull it off this year. If there was ever a year... Actually, when Ricky called me earlier, he mentioned he wants to play tennis tomorrow. So, like, he's very available as long as... I mean, come August, that'll be different.
That's one guy. Yeah. And, like, Kevin's...
Who's not here?
Kevin's going to New York.
Yeah, but if we do it before then, aren't we planning on doing it before then? We could get 12 guys.
When's Kevin supposed to move?
I think he starts, like, same day as me, but in August. So, August 15th, I think.
Oh, you want to do... I mean, look, dude. I'm the biggest at...
Inviting yourself.
Yeah.
Or
is that not the idea?
We could all chip in a couple bucks, rent out the old Champs lot.
That would be awesome, actually.
Wait, what?
Just get one TV over there.
Dude, I used to be the most envious little fuck when I was 16. I'm working the host stand. And these guys come in.
They
would come in with the big fucking draft.
Wait, you can.
They shut those glass doors. You know that room?
Yeah, these.
When you said Champs lot, I thought you meant a piece of the parking lot. I was like, what are you talking about?
Just get fucking lawn chairs.
I was so down for that. That was like Collins. Not at all, because Ron had a pool.
I was in the pool. Yeah. I was just splashing around.
Aiden was my sticker bitch, I remember.
I think he was the whole leagues.
Yeah. No, but I was saying something along the lines of that, but, like, at the same time, I can't bring half these guys out in public, man. Including you. Probably just, like...
I can respect that.
Like...
No, why don't you name out all of us?
You, Noah, Josh, Ben, Chuck, Kevin, Jake...
Oh,
Tim.
This is the whole league.
It's everyone but Brian.
And Colin?
Colin's cool.
Damn. Sounds like an awesome squad. The nine of us will go draft somewhere in private. You guys will be on TV somewhere, I'm sure.
We'll be at Colin's pool, too. So.
Word. Colin doesn't even live there.
What? Did he move?
Well, he's in Philly. Yeah.
Whole,
he works full time.
If I want to do the draft at Collins Pool, well, that's what we're doing.
Antlease is down. Antlease is always down.
Okay.
Next.
Pause.
Not really. That's not really what I meant by
that. Word. Good. Good.
Colin, if you're listening, shut your ears.
It's.
You know what?
Nothing.
Let's call Chuck. Let's call Chuck.
Yeah, let's do it.
Hope he answers.
Tim's waiting on the call as well.
I text him. I gave everyone a little heads up.
Who else are we calling?
Tim, Josh, and Brian. Oh, no Brian?
Brian said he had to study tonight, which is completely cool.
Yeah, well, we'd have a lot of guests.
I don't know what he's studying.
I was going to say, it'd be like
I don't know what he's
my phone will die. Mike also wants to take Jeebs now, so like...
That's way too bad. Uh-oh. Look who it is.
I'm very excited to be here. I've been waiting for this episode.
Nah. Just hang up. All right, Chuck, welcome to Ode to Javid Best. We've been talking about you for the first 15 minutes.
I didn't roll snake eyes, by the way. That seems important to let you know. Still no draft pick trading.
What was that last part?
There's no draft pick trading because I didn't roll snake eyes.
Yet.
No.
That might be too close.
Too close, you think?
We might be raping the listeners.
Chuck, after the last episode we released, you kind of hit the group me hard, you know, coming at my neck saying false claims are thrown around. You're here now, man. Let's duke it out.
I'm trying to get viewers to your program, so I'm throwing out.
We got plenty of those.
So you're telling me
to try to help you guys out. I saw the last one at 21 views. We're throwing out. They're like, I can't believe Chuck said this. And like me, like the thumbnail me with like an oh no face going on. Like that'll get the people going.
Holy shit, 21 views.
That's kind of bad, bro.
How's that bad?
Who's listening to that?
Because they're probably all Sean.
Well, that would be bad because we played Taps twice last week.
So there was just a hoax? reburying the hatchet?
I honestly don't really. I think I was a couple weeks ago. I don't remember what was said. It was something about you being commissioner, though.
Which you were not. Do you, wait, you say and I spirit, am not?
Spirit, you're like how. Not to be like political, but no.
Whoa, chill out.
Wait, like chill. So you're telling me?
Frank falls out the window and he cracks his head, and they're like, "Oh, who's the president?" He's like George Bush. He's like, "No, I just kidding. It's John Cheney." He pulls all the strings. Like you're the face, but I'm more so the puppeteer.
True.
I never thought about that.
So I'm technically commissioner, but you're the brains behind the operation. I'm just the big brawny commissioner.
You're the face of the league. I've said it for years.
Wow.
But I'm not the commissioner is what you're saying.
I want it on record that...
I want it on record that I have a text from you, Chuck, that says, the reins are yours whenever you want it. I have that text. I showed Chris.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you just threatened to quit the league and get what you want.
You want to break you or whatever? Whenever you or Brian would be the person that I'll give it to, and for you, it's you... You need to go through a season where you don't threaten to leave the league like every 4 or 5 weeks. So if you can do that this year, it's definitely like...
No, it's mine this year. that's for sure. That's for damn sure. I kicked out Sean for you. I that's the hardest thing anyone could have done.
That's accurate, because I never would have done that.
It's like putting your dog down.
It's not like putting your dog down. That thing was dead already.
Yeah, that's the idea. But yeah, I wanted to say that
he joined, so everyone's finally in officially.
Oda Java Best Episode 1 is joint 18th highest views on Crossman Gaming's YouTube.
That's terrible.
No, it's not that bad because I have like so many videos, like 100 at least. I have a few with zero views. Not even I watch them.
Chuck, we actually have a nice little Mount Rushmore prepared for you tonight. Feel like could grab some good answers. We're doing Mount Rushmore of your personal most hated athletes.
Biggest pussies in the life of Draymond Green.
Everyone's guessing my or like all
of our. No, that'd be too easy. It'd just be Justin Jaworski 4 times.
Oh, Ganias.
Nestor Diaz, actually.
Wait, why would we have to be picking yours? Don't you pick?
No. He's saying he was confused by the prompt. We're all picking our own.
The phrasing, I thought you were picking, like, all of my most hated athletes.
Oh. Well, fuck my phrasing, then.
2 claps.
Nestor Diaz.
We're just all picking our most hated athletes.
Yep. Yeah.
And Pepper has the most hateable list.
Yeah. And then we'll put it in the group chat and we'll figure it out.
Yeah, just like we did last week, or longer than last week, but just like we did last time with the best rivalry name, which, who won that? Yeah. Was it Kalkal versus Kev? Is that who won?
I don't think
that's... I think it was the Battle of Drexelbrook.
No, it definitely wasn't. I think it was Colin and Kevin.
Sure as hell wasn't mine, because I can never remember the name.
Yeah, bro, it's the Battle of Eric Coach Taylor's Love. The winner gets Tim Riggins.
Oh, yeah, that is good. That's actually pretty good.
All right, Chuck, start thinking. Start brainstorming here.
Yeah, you get first pick as our guest.
I have a note somewhere. Oh, you know what? I don't know if I have it anymore. I had my most overrated athletes list, but I dropped my phone in the toilet after my birthday because I made that around my birthday. So I don't think I have
it. That sounds like an awesome story that I haven't heard before.
So we got a draft. We're drafting here.
Yeah. I think we should all roll for it. Chuck, pick a number between 1 and 12.
7.
You idiot. Highest goes first. Here, Tom, you go first. You roll now.
Wait, what?
I did that.
Should have picked 12. You would have gone first. Oh, Tom got 4.
But I rolled a double. Can I go again?
Nope. Jake, your turn.
Jake rolled an 8.
7.
What? 8. 2 plus 6.
I could have swore that 8. Was a 5.
And I got a 9. All right, so we'll go me, and then Jake, then Charles, and then Tom.
Gotcha. And you can be oddly specific, too. Like, it doesn't just have to be. Okay.
I came up with this idea. I put 0
I was coming up with a list earlier.
How about we go lowest to highest, then, because I have a great start.
All right, go ahead.
Takes,
honorable guest can go second. All right. Number one, he's not taking the George Washington spot. He's just... First one to come to mind is Patrick Mahomes in the Geico commercial with the fucking beanie.
Oh, when he's the sneakerhead?
Yeah.
Sneakerhead Patrick Mahomes is number
State Farm one.
Yeah, oh, State Farm.
Yeah, that's good.
Sneakerhead Patrick Mahomes.
That's good.
He's on there for sure.
This is a weird bar that we've set for Charles at second pick now, though. What do you got?
No, I have a great one. So, my most hated athlete of all time is Alfred D'Elia.
Who's that?
He is the every Little League World Series year.
Oh, Big Al. Big
Al. My name's Alfred D'Elia. They call me Big Al, and I hit bangers. They didn't even make the Little League World Series. And every fucking year, I have to hear that kid talk about how he wants to hit bangers on SportsCenter's reels or their TikToks. Like, we're promoting mediocrity. We're promoting losers, and it's not right. And he is the poster child.
We're promoting.
There's someone else who also promotes that. But Alfred D'Elia is way worse than the other person. And I don't want to give them away because I'm not going to double dip in that pot.
Sure, just hates fat people.
Pablo Sandoval is my next pick. All right, Jake, you're up.
Mine is first one, most hated. This is probably not going to go over well with a lot of people, but I hate Luka Doncic.
Mm.
I think he is probably the biggest pussy in the NBA. And the league promoting him every year as this MVP godlike talent when all he does is bitch at every time he doesn't get a call. He misses a shot, he puts his head down, it's a 5-on-4 the other way that results in a point. He's a fag, a pussy, and my least favorite athlete.
Okay. Wow, during Pride Month, say that?
Yes. That's how strongly I dislike Luka Doncic.
Isn't this the same time that you had an incident at Citizens Bank Park during Pride Month?
Almost a year.
Oh my God. It's over now.
This month is bringing back. I actually don't hate that pick. Luka Doncic is. I love Luka, but I could, like, he bitches a lot.
I hate watching him. Like, LeBron's getting to that point, too. In terms of just, like, being annoying.
All right, I'm going to stay in basketball for my pick. I wasn't actually thinking of this until you said Luka Doncic, but easy for me, biggest pussy of all time is Russell Westbrook. I hate Russell Westbrook with every fiber of my being.
Terrible take.
All he does is he whores out for triple doubles. I'm not going to say anything gay about it because it's June. But all he does is stand under the rim, get rebounds, hold the ball for 23 seconds, force the ball to a teammate, try to get assists, and if he's shooting shots, he's probably bricking it off the backboard, missing the rim. And I'm tired of people telling me, like, oh, like, when he averaged a triple-double, it was, like, the best season. Like, it's stupid. I'm tired of hearing about how great Russell Westbrook was, how great he can be. Like, even Darvin Ham is pissing me off now, being like, oh, yeah, we're definitely going to ride out Russell Westbrook. That's just awesome. The new Lakers coach? The new
Lakers coach.
Like, he done fucked up. What?
What did you want him to say? He just got hired by the Lakers. And he's
I wanted him to put his foot down.
His last name is Ham.
Yeah, he's about to go ham.
No.
Okay.
Lunch meat.
So is it my pick again?
Yeah. It was,
all right, I'm going to stay in basketball and take an uber-specific pick in basketball, but it's Damian Lillard in the one game where he shot that game-winning three over Chandler Parsons in the playoffs. That's it. It's the only reason.
That's
soft.
Well, I'm excited to hear your next pick then, Tom.
Too bad you don't have to wait. Is it my turn? Yeah.
Yeah, it's you.
My next one. Tim's not going to like this. Conor McGregor.
Ooh. I'm with it.
He's kind. I just think he used to be able to walk the fucking, all that talk he used to do.
Walk the walk is what you're looking for.
But now I just think he runs his mouth too much. He's not nearly as good. He's washed. Dustin Poirier is a lot better.
True.
The dude breaks his fucking ankle and he's still chirping about how he should have won that fight. Sitting on his ass.
His wife.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good
pussy.
Pick.
Conor McGregor. Pick.
The more you speak it into existence, I actually don't like him.
He also attacked Khabib's bus with a fucking bunch of chairs and goons, and like Rose Namajunas was on there. She weighs 105 pounds.
Yeah, the dude walks around like he's number one.
And he hasn't been for a while. No, that's a good pick.
Yeah, I like that. So everyone knows that I'm a huge fan of West Point Army. That's Beat Navy. It pains me to say.
Don't say Diego Fuga.
One of my hated, most hated athletes. played at this school in the 60s. Got to go with Muchachevsky. Dude is just all time. Oh,
dude, that's great. That is so
he was
good.
On my list.
I mean, where do you even begin? He accounts for like 50% of Duke's basketball budget. Has by far like the most paid coach in the NBA, but says he does it for college basketball. Says he does it for the kids and all this. He plays it up for the cameras. He is all time scumbag.
Yeah, I agree.
Horrible human being.
I really like that. Like I could go piggyback right off that because I actually do have someone right up the same alley that I think is a genuine piece of shit. Yes, you know what? I'll throw him up there. Jim Boeheim.
Because he killed someone?
Dude, he killed two people and he coached like...
The next day,
2 days later. And he's just acting like he's walking around like shit doesn't... Like it didn't happen.
I'm about to throw Brian Kelly on my list.
He got a standing out.
Did he actually...
I swear to God.
I'm pretty sure he did.
Yeah, dude, you know what, bro? He's taking the fucking George Washington piece, bro. Imagine Jim Boeheim with the George Washington cut with blood all over his face, too.
And his hands, and more his hands specifically. Over,
yeah.
Yeah, you're back-to-back now.
Yeah, I know. Fuck.
I thought of a great pick while Charles was speaking.
I had a good one in my head.
I got Steve Farm, Patrick Mahomes, and Jim Boeheim.
Yeah, you got Sneakerhead Pat and Jim Boeheim.
Sneakerhead Patrick Mahomes.
I don't know. I could go a couple ways here. I think, I don't know. Like as a childhood, like one of my most hated players, Jason Wynn.
I love Jason Wynn. I used to call myself Jason Wynn.
I'm not gonna put him up there. He's like a close head. Like he's like one of the rocks that are like supporting the foreheads. But he's not one of the
pillar rocks.
Damn, I don't know. I really.
You can lose it.
Nah, you know what? Nah, I'm going to throw Jalen Hurts there, too. Just to piss off Jake. Because he is one of the sorriest fucking quarterbacks in the league. And I hate the praise that he gets.
I don't think he gets much praise.
Dude, he does. Dude,
well, you're just comparing him to fucking Danny Dimes. Who gets no praise.
At all.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. I feel like more people shit on Jalen Hurts than give him praise, from what I've seen, personally.
Well, he does. I'm saying, but the amount of people that defend him too, and they think the Eagles are something too. Like, don't even get me started on that. Chuck, what do you think? This is Super Team 2.0?
No.
I actually do think we're gonna be pretty good this year. Yeah, I do agree about Jalen Hurts though.
Jalen Hurts is an actual fucking bum, bro, and he cannot throw the ball for shit. I don't care if he can run. Danny Dimes can run. Jalen Hurts can't throw the ball. I hate to be that guy, but it's like, what did Tim just say? Hey, let me on the pod. Nah, I'm not going to add you on the pod, Tim.
I lost my pick.
I lost mine too. There was someone in my head.
It's taking too long.
So, my thing right now is Sneakerhead, Pat Mahomes, Jim Boeheim, and Jalen Hurts.
Unfortunately, I don't have one that's going to top my Coach K and Alfred D'Elia at three here, but I'm going to go with Derrick Rose, and I think... This is in the same ilk as Jalen Hurts, in that like people act like he reinvented basketball in 2011 with his MVP, and like what if like he could have if he didn't tear his meniscus and all that. The truth of the matter is that he stole the MVP from LeBron. He never should have been the MVP that year. People were just real salty that LeBron ditched Cleveland, and Derrick Rose really wasn't that special of a player. He also cheated on his SAT, which cost the Memphis Tigers 38-win season in college, and also he bricked. He went 2-for-4 at the free throw line in the final minute and didn't guard Mario Chalmers well enough. He should have taken a foul to send him to the line to shoot two. Always foul up three late, and Derek, he really choked that game away. So,
are you a Memphis fan? Is that what I'm hearing?
I'm a fan of the game. I'm a fan of playing the right way. A fan of Justin Timberlake. He's a Memphis fan.
True that. All right, Jake.
I had to bring him up since Chris brought him up in the last
one. Yeah, I was trying to hold myself out, but now that we're talking about him, my God.
Suit and tie.
I mean, I'll keep it in the NBA. Just keep it as a point guard. Trae Young is my next one.
No.
I think it's mostly just because of that Sixers series against the Hawks.
I like
that shit. I just hated seeing him pull up from half court and just draining it every fucking time. But now, ever since then, every time I see his little 6'1", balding head on the fucking floor, just running around thinking he's like Steph Curry, it just pisses me off.
That's good. That's good. I thought of this when you were talking about Coach K in terms of just being the worst in general. And as I was watching the Phillies game, my mind went to baseball, and I decided that the man who got knocked out by Billy Football about a year ago, Jose Canseco, should be on my list. Because, let's face it, he ruined the best era of baseball ever by telling people that everyone was using steroids. Like, he just...
Wasn't he using them?
Yeah. Like, that was the whole thing. Like, he watched all these guys doing way better than him on steroids and got pissed off about it. And then he ruined baseball. Like, baseball was going to die in the late 90s until anabolic steroids became prevalent. And then saved baseball, and now everybody who was a part of that is just excommunicated from everything in terms of baseball. And that's because of Jose Canseco being a selfish prick and wanting to write a book. And that sucks.
You're still up.
Ah, shit.
On the turn.
last pick.
I want to go with NBA Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum. I only ever see him on lottery night.
When was he an athlete?
You picked Coach K.
Coach K plays sports, though.
He played at Army.
Okay, you picked Alfred D'Elia. He's fat.
He's an athlete.
He's a Little League legend.
Okay, well,
according to SportsCenter.
I bet Mark Tatum played Little League baseball, too.
All right, fine.
I've been to his house.
Mark Tatum, I don't even want to hear the explanation.
I've been to his house. He's got a nice house. He never picks the Sixers to pick first, and when he does, they pick shitty players.
That's accurate.
All right, Jake. Last head.
There's definitely more people that I hate more than this guy, but this is the only one that's coming to mind, and Sidney Crosby. Mm-hmm. And I think it's just because he was... Hockey. I just tend to hate people who are good and... dickheads. So yeah, that's really the only explanation I got about it.
Chuck.
Oh, am I up?
Yeah.
Okay. Last one. I mean, the man died. R.I.P. But Kobe Bryant. where to even begin? Like, the guy has set every record for missing and being just a friggin' jack volume inefficient shooter, and people idolize that for some reason. No one brings up that he went 4-for-24 in Game 6 of the 2008 Finals that cost his team the series against the Celtics. The whole Denver fiasco, if you don't know what I'm talking about, look it up. He's just bad human being, and just one of the most overrated athletes of all time, if not the most overrated athlete of all time. Can't stand Kobe, and it's mostly not his fault, but it's mostly his fans' fault. But Kobe's just not my type of basketball player, so he's on my hate list.
I just looked up what the Denver thing was, and yeah, look it up on your own.
Yeah, it's like being like, oh, like I love Bill Cosby's, Fat Albert, like. Can you separate the art from the artist? I don't know.
Yeah, to wrap it up, last head on mine. I don't even want to go into detail because I could probably go on for days and now like my blood's boiling just thinking about it. Megan Rapinoe.
In June?
Really?
Come on.
It has nothing to do with fucking that, dude. I was thinking about it. I was like, what are the... I'm not sexist, but man, I fucking hate women's sports.
Brittany Griner would have been a good pick.
That's what I was thinking too. I'm like, you're just overrated as shit. Or like Sue Bird. They're like, oh, like you think you're so sick, like you try to guard Sue Bird. And so I will. I literally will clamp her. All it took was
didn't the women's national team, the soccer team, lose to a high school team?
Yes. Dude, and like she's like, we don't get paid enough. Bro, put some numbers up.
Put your money and not your phony up.
You know what I mean? And she's like super into the politics of everything too, or like and just like the like political realm, and it's just like always giving her 2 cents. And it's like, bro, like you have no hair, like you cut your like I can't.
That's a good point.
Yeah, who was? I think it was like Skylar Diggins, mate. I don't want to attribute this quote to the wrong person. They were like, oh, like Harrison Barnes got a huge contract, and they're like, oh, like I've accomplished more than WNBA than Harrison Barnes in the NBA. It's like, do you understand how business works at all? Like,
Harrison Barnes has a ring. Last time I checked,
is he really?
Yeah.
He went with the Warriors?
Yeah.
That dude's a bum.
And then he went and got paid by the Mavericks.
He's piggybacking Jason Witten, holding up the rocks on my Rushmore. Fuck him.
Yeah, I'm going to put Thibaut Courtois on my pillars, my Mount Rushmore, for what he did to Liverpool a couple weeks back.
Is he replacing Mark Tatum?
That's a weird pick. Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum.
Mark Tatum was a strange pick.
That was for Colin.
Well, Chuck, I think that's probably all we have in store for you. We had no other fun games, especially because we.
All right, and any like fantasy football related? I did just send in the thing about. I'm trying to stay on the same block. But is there anything like question wise you wanted to? Since you guys are the main media of the league now.
It's literally so funny you asked this because we spent the first 10 minutes being like, yeah, but none of us fucking read that. That's bullshit. I'm the commissioner. I said, it doesn't matter. You could propose any sort of league change. It's got to go through me anyway. Yeah. No, it was a pleasure having you, man. We're definitely going to have you on probably every podcast just because, you're great.
You're a staple.
Yeah. You're washed. You're a washed pod guy.
And you don't do much at night.
Yeah. What was that?
You don't do much at night.
That's not true.
True.
He's at the bar right now.
Yeah, I locked myself in the
bar. Matt Ryan's.
I would love to. First, thanks for having me. I'm never usually a guest on things. I'm usually a host of things. So it's cool being on the other side one. And then also, if you wanted to have me on post draft or whatever, or after league, I don't know, whatever. If you want to get,
You'll honestly, God, Chuck, you'll probably be on the next one. We'll figure something out.
All right, awesome. Would love to.
All right, man.
All right, see you later.
Fucking guy.
That was good.
Yeah, no, he's the Alfred D'Elia pick was really good. That made me laugh.
I got a.
Alfred D'Elia and Sneakerhead Mahomes is the first two picks.
Yeah, there's just
no
matching.
Cross my mind.
I had to pick Damian.
How does this
Lillard.
Not come across your mind, dude? That's terrible.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking
about.
Chris,
this might have to be the new thumbnail.
Sneakerhead Mahomes. That's clickbait. Can we give him a massive pair of titties?
Fucking guy, dude.
That's terrible. He doesn't look like a pussy in it.
That's bad. I also do hate Chris Paul in that one State Farm commercial where he's just floating there. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, when it's like the photo shoot.
Can any of my can any of the guys in the league help me out here? Does anybody know if Cliff and Chris Paul are actually related?
I think Kevin probably is. That's awesome.
I'm gonna call Josh. I feel like we are.
I gotta get the names.
Check how much time we're at right now. I think
probably
like 40 minutes already.
Yeah, 42.
Oh my god, dude! All right, Josh is coming on. We're doing.
We'll have to tell Tim next time.
We're doing something important for the league right now. What if we just did the same fucking Mount Rushmore with Josh right now? And we're all like,
we all picked four new ones?
Oh, I don't know. No. We all picked the same ones, but we're all just like, oh, I don't know. Like, maybe, like, oh, I'll do Sneakerhead Mahomes.
The Phillies are up two now. Both of your bets are fucked.
Yeah, I know.
Wilson Contreras is two for two tonight. Two home runs. Two dingers.
Yo, what's up, boys?
You're on the pod.
How you doing?
Pretty good, I can't lie. We just got off the phone with ex-commissioner Chuck. Kind of got us thinking about a little bit more about our league instead of just talking about random shit. And that's why we called you, because we got to figure out our draft order now, not draft order, because that's baseball. Because me and Josh love baseball, and you two hate it.
Yeah, I'm glad to be talking to Josh, not about baseball.
What'd you say?
Big seam heads, you and I.
Absolutely. Who had the better record last year? You were Josh.
I did. I was the best team in the league.
Okay, cool. So Josh gets first pick.
I get first pick because of that?
Yeah. But Josh, you also. What's the name of your division? You have to claim it right now.
I'm going to just stick with the Bunman Football Conference.
I thought
that
was going to be me.
Shit. I wanted to change it to the Bunman Football League.
Bunman Football Conference with the first pick. And the most disrespectful pick, may I add. Who are you taking?
Yeah, I'm taking Ricky.
No! Oh, wow. There goes the other division name.
That's Pete.
That's so
he
fucked.
He took Pete.
Yeah, I mean, I'm feeling, for a football guy, he's not very good at fantasy football.
Oh, we're going to have
Ricky Revenge. Clip that.
Looking at the baseball standings, he's pretty low down there.
Oh, that does not mean anything. I can speak that
two for different sure. sports.
That means all right, nothing.
Chris, what's your division name?
What
did I name it last year? Just the Yale Bulldogs division.
Yeah, Yale Bulldogs.
Yeah, it literally says the Yale Bulldogs division here.
Might as well carry on the legacy.
Yeah, I'll do the Yale Bulldogs League because that's how they do
nah,
it.
No,
do it.
Make something new.
He doesn't work for Yale anymore. Do you like what's his like?
Yeah,
what's his
true.
Dad's name?
Pete.
Sam.
Just do like Sam Venuto. Pete.
Sam Venuto Sticky Buns.
Yeah, sure.
not even conference after. Just Sam Venuto Sticky Buns.
Sam Venuto Cinnabon.
Cinnabon Sticky Buns League.
No, obviously.
My first pick is Tim. That's all I. You guys are making me say stupid shit. I just want to pick Tim and move on. Do I have another pick now?
Is it a snake draft or is it a fixed draft?
Well, it seems fair to be snake because I was the best team. You made me go second.
Snake.
Josh, yeah, we can do snake. That's fair. I think that's fair.
See, I feel like
now that Sean's out of the league, it's like
I want to have an awesome division, and I think the only way to make it awesome is to put my rival in it. So I'm gonna take Bun Man with my second pick.
Ben with the third spot taken in the Sam Venuto Cinnabon League.
That's awesome.
All right, Josh, you're up.
You know, this one's more of a favorable pick out of respect. I'm going with Chuck.
Oh.
I think we have some respect for each other's franchises, but I also see him around hovering the 6-7 area in baseball. Not the first round pick.
I like that.
Is there about to be a direct correlation between baseball what? Performance and football performance?
Doubt it.
We're going to have to.
Because sure as hell wasn't so far between football and baseball.
Yeah.
And then for the next, I'm taking Colin.
Oh, that's a good. That's a.
I like that.
That's a dude. He got picked late.
He was last year's champion.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, and I'm feeling there's a trend in our league where the champion usually hovers around 500 or worse, so I'm banking on that trend to continue.
Yo, Josh, also just a heads up, your conference name is Bunman Football Conference on a Hill. Just like
that. I can dig it. I like that.
These are the worst division names I've ever seen. Bunman Football Conference on a Hill in San Venuto Cinnabon League.
Wait, who's this? Oh, yeah, you know, I'm going to pick last year's Snarttown Blows Cock for my division.
Who's that?
Next.
That's
Jake.
Me.
Oh.
And that's my
Chris,
fourth team,
Tim,
right?
Ben, Jake.
That's a
yeah, you still
fun.
Got two more.
That's a fun division, league, whatever the fuck it is.
I'm going to be fucking ecstatic if I'm in the fucking bun, man. God, that division sucks.
Give me. This is hard, man. I don't know.
You got some damn good players
just,
left.
Just there's make
three,
it fun. Make
there's
it
three
fun.
Teams left, right?
Me, Bry Guy, and Kevbot.
Kevin.
I want Kevin to be with Colin, so I'm going to let Josh pick him.
Is Josh going to pick him, though? He doesn't have
no,
to.
No, fuck. I was trying to avoid that.
You don't have to pick him.
Yeah, why would you say that?
Oh, shit. Fuck yeah, I'll pick Kevin. I want Kevin. I wanted to keep some rivalries together, but I'll take Kevin as my fifth pick. The San Benito Cinnabon League is going to be something to fuck with, you know? Most people won't get through it.
Whenever that goes fucking 8's pretty good in fantasy football.
Well, dude, that's last year. I feel like there were a lot of teams hovering at 500.
I made it at 6-7.
There was four teams above 500 last year.
I think I was 500.
Are we still an 18 playoff?
Yeah, which I think we should talk about. It should be six.
It should be seven.
Six.
Seven. No, I like
or
seven.
Seven with a bye. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, there'd be one bye, three teams play in the first, or six teams play in the
three
first
way
round.
Championship. Make it manual. Have the bottom three teams duke it out, and then the
that
winner
doesn't even make sense.
All right, whatever. All right, you're up, Josh.
All right, I get two more picks. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is tough because I'm trying to think. Like, I have two in mind, but it basically makes it the same conference as last year.
Wait,
so what
really?
I'm gonna do, Tom? I'm gonna take you to make the conference a little bit different.
And then your last pick, take Brian, dude. I feel like he's overrated. Brian, don't listen to this podcast. Please.
He's listening.
I know. You're not.
I mean,
I love you.
I'm going to have to go with my boy Noah because I always like beating his ass. So,
dude.
Which means Brian rounds out the San Venuto Cinnabon League.
Yeah, he does.
So, the Bun Man Football Conference on a Hill. Josh, Ricky, Chuck, Colin, me, and Noah. And the Sam Venuto Cinnabon League is Chris, Tim, Ben, Jake, Kevin, and Brain.
That is an awesome.
That's a great conference.
I picked that so well. Holy shit.
So is it guaranteed that, yeah, we should make it a thing that, like, no one from our division even has to make it. Like,
no, what, first top six.
So that the Bunman Football Conference on a hill can show its dominance and go 6-0 and take every playoff spot.
No, but 17.
Oh yeah, the 17.
Reese Hoskins went yard again.
No, that's a double though. 8-4 fills. Let's go. Holy this is shit, awesome,
dude. What an inning. Has this been one inning?
No, it was multiple. Yeah. Anyways, that's awesome. We did it.
Yeah, I think that's all we have for you. I mean, we probably did have a Mount Rushmore, but we just did it with Chuck, and that took like 30 minutes.
Yeah, but we can hear who you would put on your.
Oh, yeah.
No, all good. You can call me on one of the other ones. I'll love to be on two of the pods.
We'll have you do it now. We just won't participate. We did Mount Rushmore of your four most hated athletes personally.
Most hated athletes. Oh shit.
Your personal.
That's tough. Sidney Crosby.
That was on Jake's list as well.
Probably DeMarcus Cousins.
Boogie Fever. I forgot about that with you, Josh.
I can't even think.
Yeah, it was tough. I mean, I could barely think, and I had gaps in between our picks because we were doing a draft.
If it makes you feel any better, Josh, my fourth pick was NBA Deputy Commissioner Mark Tatum. I couldn't think of anybody.
That's a good one. I mean, I'll probably go with Draymond because I think he's a piece of shit and he's bad at basketball.
That was the preface for this draft, so it makes sense.
Yeah, and then I guess I'll have to round it out with Tom Brady.
Really?
Not a big Tom Brady guy.
I've got a sixth pick that I think Josh might like. Tim Thomas, old Bruins goalie. That guy was a piece of shit. And he was like the face of the NHL when the Bruins won that one cup, and that pissed me off to no end.
Yeah. Actually, I should get rid of Tom Brady out there because I am starting to like him a little bit, and I'll put Patrick Kane for...
Being
a scumbag and also beating the Flyers in game six.
The old redliner.
Yeah.
People don't forget.
It's pretty good Rushmore. We're going to drop all of them in the chat. We're going to see who's got the best, most hated. And you'll see from there who we picked. But, yeah, Josh, thank you for hopping on. I mean, you drafted a pretty shitty division, which is good. Which is really good.
Well, thank you for having me, boys.
Yeah, of course.
Excited for the season.
I got a feeling that we're going to mimic fantasy baseball and fantasy football, Josh. We'll be at the top of our division.
I'd imagine.
I see it now. I bet it goes me, you, Colin, Ricky, Noah, Chuck. Boom.
I'll put Chuck at the bottom. I see.
Sorry, Chuck. You're going to draft like fucking... We'll pick. Let's call him seven.
Tom Top, Chuck Bottom. My new fantasy team name.
I hope he takes Nick Chubb so we can still be the Chubble Space Telescope.
That's good. Yeah, that's good.
He's going to reach on he's going to take Stephon Diggs at seven and then wonder why. and then he's going to wonder why his season went to shit. But all right. Thanks, Josh.
Catch you all later. Later, boys.
Peace.
Cracker.
Yo, we're still recording, dude.
I know.
No, I Josh, know you.
Cracker.
No, great guy though. Really glad to talk to him about something that isn't fantasy baseball. Because then I get upset because he's like, "Oh yeah, if he's 100 points down for me, like shut up, dude."
That was me. I thought.
Yeah, but I want Paul Goldschmidt. Nobody's giving him to me.
I texted Colin for him. I'm trying to poach.
You should start texting Noah.
Trying to poach around here.
You gotta text the right people, dude. That's like a big part of it. So I say we save Tim for the next pod.
I'm not calling Tim.
Yeah, we'll just leave him on the hook. He's gonna be sitting at work, twiddling his thumbs, like, "Ooh, my best friends are gonna call me soon," and never get that call.
Facts.
I'm gonna text him after we are done recording and be like, "Yeah, just be ready anytime in the next 30."
How much time do we have now? Because you have to keep it under an hour, don't you? Or else it's
It's 54. Theoretically, I don't think we need to keep it at under an hour.
So fucking dumb, dude. Why did we use the song again? Isn't it gonna have to get like go through the copyrightage?
No, that doesn't matter. I just won't be able to monetize it, but...
Oh, well, fuck that. What am I doing this for? Why am I sitting around a fucking table for 50 minutes?
You think I'm just willing to monetized. Talk for an hour for free?
We do need an outro song, though, which we haven't thought about Taps. Yet.
Plug Travis's shit.
True, yeah, that's good. It's literally called This Shit. Hey, if you guys want to go listen to The Musea on Spotify, it's one of my... artists that I manage. I'm a talent manager. I'm looking to get more under the Scalise umbrella. Maybe a Canvas. Maybe a KD. I don't know. Something like that.
As our pause move on.
Maybe an Ace Sherrill.
Wait, what?
Was that last one?
Ace Sherrill.
Oh, Alex Sherrill.
Does he make music?
Yeah, he dropped an album.
I'm thinking next podcast, whatever the fantasy baseball standings are by the time the night that we do it, maybe we'll do a little mock draft. Maybe start getting into the logistics of fantasy football a little bit.
I like that.
I mean, I've been mocking. It's getting me excited. I'm so horny.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost July, which means almost July is, you know, 1 month away from fantasy football.
True that.
So, like, a month and a half.
That's epic.
And I want to maybe brainstorm some ideas on maybe organizing a draft somewhere. If we could do it at, like, a place, but, like... Realistically speaking, probably someone's house would be better.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. If we're trying to do something like that and you want me to, like, chip money, you're going to have to wait until, like, middle August.
You work.
Yeah, not till middle of July, though.
Yeah.
I'm not going to get my first paycheck till at least, like, the 29th
you paid July. Monthly?
Well, I start the 15th.
Oh, sure, yeah. Yeah, well, maybe you can't play this year.
Oh. I got a song playing right now. Should we wrap this up?
Yeah, sure. All right, thanks for listening, guys. We ain't never left. We just moved the silence and left to the death. It's official. I survived what I've been through. Y'all got drama. The saga continues.
We ain't going nowhere. Because it's bad boys for life.